Welcome back to a new video. I hope you all had a good weekend. So today we're going to be doing a set of embossed pumpkin nails. I've got Sunstalker, that's the gel polish we're using. And then I've got Tangerine Dream glitter from Nail Sugar. I've got Glow Orange gel paint and the orange gel paint as well. So for this set of nails, we're going to have like a gradient of colours. So I'm going to start with Sunstalker. This is going to be the more browny orange of the lot. And then we're going to move on to the orange gel paint. I'm going to apply this with Madame Glam's application brush. It's like a gel brush, basically. And the good thing about these gel paints is that they can be used for full coverage as well as doing designs. So I'm doing a nice thin coat of this, and we're going to apply two coats. So for that middle colour, I'm going to mix a little bit of the orange gel paint. I say a little bit, I did put way too much on. I'm going to just clean my spatula. Then I'm going to put this glow orange colour in with the orange, and it's going to give us a colour in between the two. There we go. My palette is so mucky. It's not mucky, it's just scratched, and it's got some decal backing stuck to the bottom, which I haven't got off yet. So this is going to be, can you see, it's slightly lighter than the previous orange that we used, but it won't be as light as that glow orange that we're going to use as well. So that's that one. And I'm just going to clean the brush off. And lastly, this is the last one we're going to use. Again, I'm going to keep my coats of this thin because it's a gel paint, and I'm going to cure all these for 60 seconds. The gel polish only needs 30, but because we used the gel paint, that needs 60. Right, I'm going to do another coat. So we're going to do two coats in all. And then the gel, this is the Tangerine Dream glitter from Nail Sugar. You can get 10% off anything on Nail Sugar's website using my code NATMUG10. Right, the gel paints, look, they don't have a tacky layer. So if you go to pick up your glitter, I started to put it on and it took me a few seconds. I was like, why is that not sticking? And then I realised I'd used the gel paints. So the gel paints don't have a tacky layer when they cure. So I have to remember that. So to make them tacky, I'm going to put a thin layer of a base coat on here just so that I can get a tacky layer, because I want to, I want to burnish the glitter into the tacky layer. So I'm only going to do that. I'm not going to do it on the brown one. I'm only on the two nails that I want glitter on. And then I'll pop those in the lamp for 30 seconds. And then we can burnish on our glitter. So when you burnish glitter, it just means rubbing glitter into the tacky layer. So I kind of scoop, there was a hair on that one. I scoop a little bit out of the pot. And then scoop and then, like, I'm not getting much on my brush though, but you just dab it on and then you just sort of like rub it in like that. You just burnish it in and you're left with a nice spread of glitter. I don't know what the words are. I can't think this morning. It's too much for me. I'm only going to do that on two nails. So it just gives the nails a little bit of, you know, a little bit of something just to keep them from being too plain. And then we're going to matte top coat all of them. After I do check, right, because I've burnished glitter into these, I do check that there's no glitter on the velvet matte top coat brush before I put it back in the pot. If there is, I will just wipe the brush onto my kitchen towel just to make sure that I don't contaminate the top coat. I don't know if I said at the beginning, but you can get 30% off anything on Madame Glam's website using my code NATMUG30. I say anything, actually. Whatever's in their clearance section, you can't, that Yeah, whatever's in the clearance section, you don't get extra discount off that because that's already heavily discounted. So everything off the website, I think apart from their clearance section, you can get 30% off using my code NATMUG. 30. They look amazing already. I love matte top coats. Lovely. Right, so whatever colour I used as the base, I'm going to use that same colour to create the pumpkins. So all we're literally doing is we're going to create the embossed looking pumpkins now. If you're using the gel paint, you don't actually have to use the acrylic like I'm going to use. You can just use the gel paint like this. It will leave the pumpkins looking shiny. If you want to do the embossed look with acrylic, it does leave them looking matte. So it's entirely up to you whether you want them shiny or matte. I'm going for matte today, matte on matte. Or you could do shiny on matte, it's up to you. But the pumpkins are quite easy to do. I'll tell you what the hardest thing was trying to get them all the same size. I think that's the most hardest thing, but it's literally kind of like two C's like touching, and then you just do some, look, you just do some curvy lines and a stalk, and you've got a pumpkin. And then I'm going to sprinkle acrylic into the uncured gel paint, and then the gel paint is going to suck up the acrylic powder, and that's how it's going to look matte, because it's sucked up that acrylic powder. But as I said before, you don't have to apply the acrylic. You can just cure it and you'll have a shiny pumpkin. Just if you are sprinkling acrylic on, just leave it a few seconds before you pop it in the lamp, because you'll find some areas that might still be shiny. You want to make sure that you don't have any shiny patches before you pop it in the lamp. And then I like to double cure this. So if I'm doing this with gel polish, the gel polish will take 30 seconds to cure. So I will give it 60 seconds. But because this is gel paint, I normally give it about a minute and a half. I just like to make sure it's definitely cured, so I like to just over cure it slightly. And then when it comes out, I will brush off the excess acrylic powder on the nail, and you're left with a cute little embossed looking pumpkin. I'm going to do exactly the same thing on all the other nails. I'm going to just add a second pumpkin to the bottom. So I want, like, this one was a little bit more harder to do. But yeah, I'm just going to add random pumpkins, did I say that right, to all four of the nails. Obviously I've only done four nails. If you're going to do it on a real person, you're going to need to do five. I would just do maybe a slightly darker brown or a slightly lighter orange, just to continue that gradient of colour. Is that the right word? I think it is. So again, look, I'm just sprinkling my acrylic. I dab it off, I'll have a look to make sure there's no shiny bits, and if there is, I will just give it another sprinkle to, it's obviously not sucked up enough acrylic powder. There we go. And then once I'm happy, I'll shove that in the lamp, give it a overcure, and then brush off the excess, and we've got like a little embossed pumpkin. So I'm going to do that on all of these nails. And then I decided that if your client likes a little bit of bling, I thought we'd add some crystals. So what am I doing? I was just looking. I like the glitter underneath as well. I just think it adds a little bit of something extra. These are, I know they're not orange, but these are Jonquil Preciosa crystals from the Crystal Parade. You can get 5% off these using my code NAT5. I just felt like the Jonquil went with this particular pale yellow, went with all of the orange colours and the brown in this set. So I thought, right, we'll use those, because I was going to use orange, but I've only got like a really vibrant orange. I need to see if they've got any other orange colors actually. I might treat myself at some point when I've got some spare monies, which I don't know why, because I've got enough crystals really. But I like to have lots of different colors. And we're gonna do like we did with the last Stars and Moons set. I'm just gonna do like a scatter of crystals. I do add one more crystal on this nail, but I'm gonna do the same thing. Yeah, look, I thought I needed just one more, roughly around here. And I'm using various sizes. They're not all the same size. And then I'm gonna continue that along all four of the nails. So again, the gem glue I'm using is the Nailchemy Crystal Totalist gem glue, and it's a curable gem glue, so you put it on, pop your crystals on, and then your crystals won't stick into place until you actually cure it in the lamp. It's not like an air dry glue, so you've got lots and lots of time to play with it until you pop it in the lamp. So again, I'm just going to pick up various sizes. I didn't want them to all be the same size. I thought it'd be nice to have a mixture. So I'm just going to continue that across all four nails. And then once I'm done, I will pop those into the lamp for a 60 second cure. And then that is then finished. I'll show you a quick close up. There we go. I just thought they were nice autumny nails. We're officially in October now. Anyway, I hope you like these. If you did, please leave me a like. If you haven't already, do consider subscribing. It's completely free and you can always change your mind later. God bless, and I will see you in the next one. Love you, bye.